Next, I want to talk about role conflict. Okay, in many conversations I've had with priests, pastors, and those in church leadership, all have agreed that the bishop has an incredibly challenging and overwhelming task of juggling his dual roles as CEO of a complex organization, as well as a spiritual leader, a shepherd of his flock. Research suggests that there are many factors that make it difficult for a bishop to effectively carry out his dual roles as administrator and spiritual leader. The first has to do with something in organizational behavior we call a bottom-line mentality, a type of one-dimensional thinking caused by excessive focus on securing bottom-line outcomes at the expense of other priorities, that those other priorities get crowded out when we're focused on the tasks at hand. A bishop dealing with crisis-related issues can spend the majority of his time attending to the administration of his diocese. He has many worries. Will we face lawsuits? Where will the money come from? Will I have to close parishes and schools, lay off staff? How will the local media cover bad news? What will my priests think? What will people in the pews think? It is quite possible that a bishop's administrative role is so time-consuming, so overwhelming, that he has little time left over to attend to his own mental, physical, and spiritual health and well-being. Other research shows that thinking about money, even subconsciously, can make someone more prone to poor ethical decision-making because it causes the decision-maker to focus on business considerations. In the case of bishops during the abuse crisis, this might have manifested itself as an inclination to put the needs of the institution to protect its reputation, ahead of victims and a desire for secrecy instead of transparency. Taken together, these factors suggest that there's something about a bishop's role that is uniquely challenging, both within the church and across other organizations. For example, I don't know too many CEOs of business organizations, no matter how successful they are, who could succeed if they were given dual roles for administering the business and simultaneously attending to the spiritual needs of their employees and the surrounding communities. That's a tall task. This should cause us to question, to what degree does a bishop's role as CEO of a very complex organization compromise his ability to serve as a spiritual leader to his flock?